Hey, it's Dan. Welcome back. You're watching I Allegedly. And I have a good one for you today. A really good one, in fact. You know, we get news. Get news sent to me. I look at all the different news outlets, all the different major newspapers, you know, everything from around the world. If you read these headlines and you shared them with people, the world would freak out normally. You would see the stock market drop 1,000 points on a realistic day like this. But no, you know, the bad news is nothing. You just go on about your day and you just don't accept it that it's really real. So with that being said, there's an absolute ton to cover today. Before I get into it, please take a second. Please hit the like button. Please subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell notification so you get notified of everything that we're doing. Also, we have a winner to announce. Emily S. from the state of Washington has won the 3 months free trial to foreclosure.com. So congratulations to Emily S. in Washington. You'll be notified from foreclosure.com and your account will be free for the next 90 days, which is super cool. If you guys want a 7-day trial and you want to get information on foreclosures, short sales, bankruptcy sales, all that fun stuff, it is there on foreclosure.com. Use the link below. Now, let's get into it. First things first, guys, you know, you're hearing everything about inflation to where you can't keep up with it right now. And think about this headline out of the Wall Street Journal that absolutely floored me. And I remember this as a kid at one point with living with my single mom, that it was cheaper to take us out to eat than it was to feed us at home. And what you're seeing is that it is getting less expensive to eat at some restaurants than it is to eat at home. And that is insane, guys. The nutritional value of fast food and restaurant food is rarely as good as something you can make yourself. There's that. And this is awful that we're living in times like this that people don't want to look at and accept the fact that that this is a fact right now. Now, you know, it's really weird. When I was a kid, the restaurant quality food was so much better than it is right now. It really is. But the argument is you can eat at Kentucky Fried Chicken, KFC, for around $7 for a meal when you couldn't make that meal at your house. And you can sit there and argue this, you know, all you want. The McDonald's fast food, you know, the Dollar Coke is now $1.50. Big Mac is $7 for a Big Mac right now, $6.89 for a Big Mac. That is insane, guys. I don't know how people are justifying this. You can't take your kids every day to Costco and get the $1.50 hot dog. That's not going to fly for anybody. But, you know, certain restaurants do have certain discounted meals, and this is awful. Now, one good thing that this insane state has done is this. California has just proposed that every kid in school gets a free meal. So you can have breakfast, you can have lunch at your school, regardless of your socioeconomic status, regardless of your parents' income, they will give you free lunch here in California. I hope other states follow this and do this, because it is awful to think about these kids going to school and not having, you know, any type of meal to begin with. Now, here we are halfway through August. September is Hunger Awareness Month, which is sickening, guys, that we have a month to remind you, hey, there's people going hungry. Don't forget them. And the biggest problem last year, the thing that wrenched at my heart, was schools in Alabama that had supply chain issues, where kids, the only way they were going to eat was going to those schools and getting lunches, and they couldn't get food, couldn't get milk, couldn't get anything nutritious to these children. That is horrific. There is hell to pay for the adults that are in charge, that are imbeciles, okay? Because again, people that collect paychecks, just because you have a job there doesn't mean you know what the hell you're talking about. So, you know, when my kids were young, we were out at a restaurant last night, and this family was there sitting next to us, and we got to talking to them, and they were celebrating because the kids were going back to school this week, and they were in our town. And they were going back to the same schools that my daughter went to, her elementary school, her junior high, and her high school. This family had kids in each age group, and we were talking about it and who the teachers were back then. And it had been some years since my daughter graduated high school, but it was great to talk to these people and, you know, how they're changing the administration and all that stuff. You know, I got to thinking about one thing I did, you know, when I went up and down financially and I made a decent amount of money. One thing I did when my kids were in elementary school was I was sickened by the fact that people would go out and there would be field trips for these kids. And this is, you know, we lived in a nice city, guys. It's not, you know, a lower end city. And they would make these kids, hey, listen, if you don't pay for the bus, you're not going to go on the field trip. And you would see families where it would be, they were going through the divorce, the single mom had the kids and couldn't swing it right now, paying the lawyer, paying the shenanigans and dealing with the nonsense that she's dealing with, and her kid couldn't afford this. Well, I went in and said, hey, I want to make sure that that there's never an issue like this. I want everybody to go on these field trips. I want everybody to go and never have an issue. And here's X amount of dollars to pay for that. If you need more, you let me know. Okay, so there was that. But I don't want anybody to know I did it, okay? And I don't want them to be, if the kids are singled out, I'm going to be furious with you guys. So they did it, kept their mouth shut. It was great. The next thing was kids with lunches. I had no idea. They had these lunch cards, and parents would go in and say, okay, you know, they'd give a kid lunch. You know, you could get these little envelopes and put your kid's money inside these envelopes, which was great. Or they could go and get these cards that you would prepay for and put money on it and then come back pay for lunch. Now, my son, you know, found out, hey, Dad prepaid for all this stuff. So, hey, everybody, I can buy everybody ice cream. Okay? And this was done a few times to the point that, hey, you need to come and replenish the card. I just did. I just brought you $40. What do you need? We need another $121. What? Okay. So my son would do that to pay for ice cream and for the entire school. It was great. Whole grade, whole class, everybody, what do you want? Then I got, I got in trouble. How dare you give kids ice cream, Dan, and not knowing if they're lactose intolerant or if they're allergic to anything. Okay, I was at work, guys. Okay, where were you? Okay. You can only imagine where this is going to go. So, needless to say, my son still jokes about that one. But in this world, it is awful that there are children out there that are not eating. And again, you can sit there and say their parents are degenerates. It's awful that they can't afford to feed their kids. They shouldn't have kids if you can't feed them. Okay. Now, flash forward about 8 years when I'm going through my divorce and, you know, spending money out of, you know, spending crazy money to get my kids half the time, okay? Things change with people all the time, and nobody wants to admit that. But look at Fran Glover, who runs that food charity, Joseph Dreamhouse. She has 40 of her clients right now that they're giving free food to right now were actually donors a little over a year ago. That's sad, guys. It's tragic that people have to live that way and that you're seeing people upside down. And again, nobody cares about this, and nobody's talking about inflation in a real light. They don't want to admit that inflation is a huge problem right now. And, you know, but hey, inflation's going away. Jerome Powell is insane right now because he's talking about how, you know, we're going to get ourselves back to the target of 2%, and the next stop is 4%. Do you believe that? Do you believe we're going to see 4% inflation right now? Because everything is going up. I spoke to a manufacturing company today who manufactures metals and aluminum, steel, screws, nuts, bolts. And the line to me was, Dan, there is no end in sight for this thing ending. There is no end in sight for tapering. There is no end in sight for slowing down. Well, what about 2%? 2%? What are you kidding? This is not going to happen, Dan. No. We're worried about getting paid from people because with this, these contractors are having trouble collecting money. These contractors are having trouble paying this guy. The receivables are growing on a weekly basis. Oh, that's interesting. So let's take a look at this really quick because it's just a really beautiful spot. You guys like the new mic? down here with all this wind. Isn't that beautiful? That's so stunning. Let's climb up here just for a second. You got all the seaweed and kelp beds out there. You can't fish in some of these areas because they're protected. And, but again, absolutely beautiful. But again, we're not supposed to worry about food. You know, I hate slang terms for things. The new vocabulary for stuff, food insecurities. How about people are going hungry, guys? People are starving. The Fed is about to drop their minutes, and that's the detail of their meeting that they had last month to let us know where they think things are headed. Where they're headed right now is to the moon. And Jerome Powell said to taper inflation, he may have to do something really drastic with the interest rates. Wouldn't it be awesome, seriously fantastic, if they raised interest rates like 1.5 points? Just rip the Band-Aid off, man, and just went live with this. Now, believe it or not, the tide is out right now. It's just so stunning. You can walk through all of that. And you got critters down there. You got crabs. You got sea urchins. You got little fish that live in there and then get swept away. It's just very cool. So what's he going to do? But what he's hinting at is something more drastic than we anticipated because of how things are. Now, all the housing talk. Scott Walters this last week, talking to the economic ninja, talking to everybody else, talking to realtors, talking to all the emails. And again, here's the thing, guys, is that this channel, I'm telling you this right now, we've got such an amazing audience of business professionals who, listen, Dan, don't use my name, don't use my city, but this is what's happening. This is what I know about oil prices. This is what I know about oil production. This is what I know about real estate, interest rates, lenders that are laying people off. I'm getting some great stuff from all these people that are pointing me in different directions to share with you guys. So any expertise that you have, let me know, okay? So, but sentiment with home builders, okay? You know, CNBC, home builders say that we're in a recession and that the sentiment is gone south and that they keep track of numbers and that we've had numbers over 80, 90% of people being positive about home building and home prices. Now it's below 50. Anything below 50, they consider to be negative, and that's where it's at right now. So look for deals. I can't confirm all this stuff, but Pulte Homes is, you know, letting people know that there's $150,000 discounts out there for houses. You're letting people know that, there's discounted or short-term rates that you can get for houses. Crazy, guys. Absolutely nuts. So, you know, what do you guys think about all this? Because I think it's the beginning of the end right now for real estate. I think you're going to start to see things come down. It's not going to happen all at once. There are hot spots in the country. There are places in the country that are going above ask and people are crazy. And you're seeing, you know, resort towns like where Scott lives up in Santa Barbara. It'll be one of the last areas to have a real, real problem. And it'll be one of the first areas to recover. Just like Laguna Beach I'm walking through right now, this city, the same thing. Now, check this out, guys. Okay. We got a weekday. But this place is so cool. This is a place called Heisler Park, and they've got all these hidden picnic areas like this. Okay, you can get the barbecue, you can sit out here and be by yourself, have your family out here and not be disrupted by anybody. Very cool. And these places are free, to get. So, I always love what's a discount. I always love what you can do for fun. And again, my daughter, we were talking about this stuff and talking about the channel and stuff that she's doing with hers. And people, it's not the money that you spend on something. It's the experience that you do. That's worth more than anything. And, you know, I'm always blown away at what you can do for free if you look. Now, living here in Southern California, there's a ton of stuff to do out here. And we're very lucky that we get access to things like this. But you've got to go and make some joy right now in your life. And people write me. They're deeply in debt, have money problems, don't know what they're going to do, don't know how they're going to get out of this. And I'm telling you guys, it's base hits, man. It's one thing at a time. You got to clean your life up one step at a time. You know, I heard a great story about improving your life 1% a week. You know, and if you could do that at the end of 50 weeks, you'd be 50% better. You know, and people talk about doing this daily and what can I do today. You got to move forward every day. But man, I'm telling you, the negative news that's out there, do not act like this is a big deal. To act like everything's okay, you're kidding yourself. You're absolutely fooling yourself. The stories that I get from around the country, from the Aldis, and from the Walmarts and the different stores and all the, you know, stores that have no food that are shut down, that don't make the news. This should be national news when a city doesn't has stores that don't have food. Huntington Beach, California, on Saturday had a power outage in half the city, and banks wouldn't work. Couldn't go to the bank. Couldn't get access to money. Again, no big deal. Just don't worry about it. Well, it is a big deal if you need to get money. It's a huge deal. But again, when do you worry about this stuff? When do you notice this stuff? When do you sit there and say, I'm going to protect myself? Have cash on hand. You know, it's funny. Yesterday, silver went down another 50 cents to be $20. I talked to a couple silver guys that I'd spoken to just a few days earlier, and like, this is insane. You know, Dan, we're not going to sell much right now because we don't want to sell. It's too low. It's too suppressed right now. So if you can get your hands in the silver, get your hands in the silver right now, guys. Couple of great stories. Scott is a good soul who drinks a lot of coffee like I do, and you know, went to go buy coffee, and it was had gone up, you know, $6 for his Folgers jar that he buys, and it's like, no, pass. Bought them online, you know, bought 10 of them online, and saved himself $50 for doing that. You can sit there and say, it's kind of ridiculous. No, guys, because what's going to happen is Scott's going to run out of one coffee and go to get the second one, and he's going to be paying $20 for that. You're going to see coffee go through the roof right now. Everything, talking about the problems that they had in Brazil, and la 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 la, getting it down here, it's awful. And then Steve sent me a great story that you need to look at, and it's, how much have your used cars gone up in your state? And I won't bore you with each state, but it's crazy, because it's just a matter of time until the prices start to come down. We're paying so much for used cars right now, and eventually it's gonna subside, and you're gonna see prices get to a realistic level. But when is that? And the parts, getting parts for cars right now is absolutely nuts right now. And what I'm being told from auto people and contractors, especially air conditioning people in hot areas like Arizona, that can't get, you know, certain condenser coils and certain things when it's 120 degrees outside, that is nuts. Now, another story was sent to me, and this is beautiful. I knew someone would keep track of this. The clown in chief, Jim Cramer. Bye, bye, bye. Lehman Brothers, it's a buy. It's great. You know, one thing he pitched last year were SPACs, these investment companies. Every single one that he told people were a buy, every single one was off, has lost money substantially. So, again, this guy has a platform to go talk about this stuff, to have you buy, 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 and everybody lost. So share your thoughts and all this stuff. Now, I would never pay for that guy's advice just to even give it to you guys, just for the entertainment. There's certain things I refuse to waste money on. That guy's a clown. That guy's a degenerate that has told people to buy things and they've lost a substantial amount of money. And it's tragic, to say the least. So share your thoughts and all this stuff, guys. Let me know what you're thinking about all this. One thing that we've all had crammed down our throats over the course of the last week is the Inflation Reduction Act. And think about this, the CBO, which is the Congressional Budget Office, okay? They said that, number one, it's gonna create $30 billion in more taxes for the middle class. That's you and I, guys, okay? So, that's Congress talking about this. That's not somebody that's just making up numbers. It's not some political organization. It is the fact that they're saying that we're going to get fleeced and that we're going to get played and tagged and then, you know, lambasted with this thing that's about to be implemented. So insanity, guys. The other thing is we're being told from several different leaders that the stock market is going to fall dramatically. And the one thing that I get a kick out of is when you get, you know, diverse groups. First one is a hedge fund that everybody talks negatively about. And they're saying, listen, we're notifying all our clients that this is finished, that this is done, and that there will be no easy end to this. And that with the Fed having to raise inflation, raise interest rates to fight inflation, it's going to destroy the stock market. BlackRock said that. BlackRock issued that warning, and it's in the video description below, but they're talking about how you're going to see nothing but chaos for stocks and stocks in the future. The next one is a guy that we all talk about and feel good about, and that's Michael Burry, who owns Zion Capital and was made famous by Christian Bale in The Big Short. And Michael's talking about how you're going to see a major stock collapse, and he sold everything. Now, here's the thing. This guy sold Facebook, he sold Twitter, he sold all this stuff that you've heard of, you know, Amazon, you know, Tesla, all the stuff that he had in his portfolio and got rid of it, common stock. And I know I'm gonna sit there and say things that it looks like he had that he may not have. But one thing that he kept was a company called Geo Company. And Geo is a private prison that he thinks is going to be a profitable venture. So that's crazy. So the private prison, he's got over 500,000 shares of this one private prison that he thinks is going to be profitable out of Florida. So if that's not telling for where the market's at right now, I don't know what is. You're going to continue to see stock manipulation. Bed Bath & Beyond, which should have been Bed Bath & Gone, they they were shorted a ton. And now they're the hot new meme stock to be shooting up in price right now because Reddit got a hold of them and told everybody to buy it. So that's happening. And again, you know, the stories I get from around the globe are crazy. Think about this. In the UK, they're raising postal prices. And listen to this. You cannot, okay, if you don't use your stamps between now and the end of the year, they're no good. So the money that you spent on stamps, you're out. Now you can get a refund, but think about this. You can do banking at the post office, but you can't go refund your stamps at a UK post office. That makes no sense. Now I had a subscriber who clearly is in the know with this and wouldn't. My name is N, okay, N, and that's it, okay? So this is terrible. But one thing you have in society, whether it's the UK or here, most elderly people prepay stamps. They buy stamps for the holidays. They buy them now. My mom used to have a drawer full of them. And it would, wow, mom, you got a few stamps here. Yeah, if I ever have to pay bills, which, you know, towards the end, she didn't pay bills. Anyways, but she had a ton of stamps. Now, the idea of a forever stamp over there is done. No such thing. And these poor people in the UK, again, the way of getting a refund is to go online, and the person said it was convoluted, to say the least. It's not just a simple transaction, and you cannot go to a post office to get stamps refunds. Nuts, guys, just nuts. And again, we're seeing more bureaucracy, more difficulty. You know, I'm getting all these different things sent to me about Aldi with their price increases, Aldi telling their shoppers, hey, we're not going to raise prices. They show up the next time and prices are higher. It's happening everywhere, guys. It's happening at our local stores here and talking to the managers, I talk to everybody I can. It's trying to maintain inventories, trying to keep things in the stores, trying to get things sold and not to lose money. But again, the employees to do price changes is a real problem with this. Share your thoughts and all this stuff, guys. I think it's horrific about the scams. You may think it's no big deal, but it's just one more way of the government trying to take advantage of people not getting a refund, not getting their money back, not taking advantage of something like that. So let me know what you guys think about this. I love when CEOs step forward and talk reality in this world. We don't get it enough. David Solomon of Goldman Sachs, the CEO, steps forward over the weekend and said, hey, listen, New York is becoming dirtier and grittier. It's more difficult to live here. It's more difficult to work here. Crime is a huge problem for us, for our workers, for recruiting. Okay. Hey guys, you're a top prospect from that university. We'd love to have you work for us. You got to be stationed in New York City. Pass. Okay. A lot of people are turning them down because they don't want to live in a crime infested area like New York. So there's that. The other thing that's crazy is Canadian real estate is having a recessionary period and it's dropping. I got to read you the numbers. This was sent to me. So I'm going to read this to you because it's kind of crazy. Home sales fell 5.3% on a month over month basis in July. Actual, not seasonally adjusted, monthly activity came in 29.3% below the previous year of July of 2021. The number of newly listed properties dropped by 5%. The MLS home price index edged down 1.7%, but was still up 10.9%. So things went down, but prices are still higher than they were a year ago. The actual, not seasonally adjusted, national average sales price posted a 5% year-over-year decline in July. Now, again, Canada's got real problems when it comes to their real estate. We all know that, and that's coming around the globe, okay? My friends that live in Canada still talk about hot markets, but then there's markets that people cannot unload their houses at. So you're gonna see this, and it's only going to exponentially get worse. I'm going to finish this video with these last few stories. And the first one has to do with self-driving cars. I love this stuff, guys. The CEO of Lyft in 2016 said, there's no need to own a car because in a relatively short period of time, there's going to be driverless cars that will take us everywhere. Okay, 2016. Elon Musk in 2015 said, it's just a matter of time until you have driverless taxis. And it still hasn't happened. Now, here's the thing we're seeing here in California, and I gotta write this down, what this organization is, but they are lambasting Tesla, talking about how their autopilot is completely unsafe, and they keep showing them running into crash test dummies time after time after time, and just taking these dummies out. And it's really nuts when you think about this. But great article, because the technology is not here, to say the least, guys. It's just not. Now, CEO of Six Flags, the amusement park, they got Magic Mountain here, they got Six Flags around the country. He said that this is a great place to babysit your teenage kids. Drop them off here at Six Flags. The Six Flags employee lost it because they're like, wait a second, we don't want to be babysitters for these kids. And they're demanding his ouster. So the workers at the amusement park are sick of this guy and saying that he needs to step down because that's not what they need to have a safe environment for kids and for people that are attending the amusement park. The final story is a settlement from Apple for $30 million for its employees. Now think about this. People worked at Apple and ended their shift. They would have to wait in line in security to have somebody inspect their bags to make sure they didn't take technology, had no zip drives, had no iPhones, had nothing, okay? And the problem with that is that it would take sometimes an hour and a half and people weren't paid. So much so that they got a hold of some labor attorney and they got a $30 million settlement for this. So This just happened at Amazon, where they did the same thing, but Amazon only settled for $8 million, $8.7 million. So again, guys, here in California, it's like if you go out to lunch and you sit down with your boss, it's considered work in some of these situations. I mean, it is crazy how you can really, I mean, these companies can get stuck by not giving you your scheduled breaks, by not letting you leave when you're supposed to leave. So I understand the security thing, but they're going to have to let people start earlier or pay them for that time in the future. So share your thoughts on all this stuff, guys. Please don't forget to hit the like button. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Congratulations to Emily S. for winning the 3 months free on foreclosure.com. They're a great company and a good group of people. Onward and upward, guys. I will see you guys very soon.